filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Really, very little idea how many people are going to show up, especially with inclement weather. The first inclement weather we've had in like 8 months or something, of course. Today is the day it decides to storm. But that's fine. We are here. God is being worshipped and praised in this holy chapel, one in which I began my maturation as a religious. St. Albert Priory is dear to the hearts of all Western Dominicans, and I am happy for the opportunity to introduce some of my Melkite friends and colleagues to this lovely place. Today we are honoring, as you can see by the icon in the center, St. Theodore Stratolatus. St. Theodore is one of the great and holy martyrs, coming at the very end of the persecution of Christians in the early 4th century. Licinius Licinianus, one of the co-emperors, decided to revive the persecution of Christians at the very kind of the last gasp of the persecutions. And St. Theodore, who was a commander in the army, one of the legionaries, refused to worship the idols, and so underwent many tortures. He was crucified, and he didn't seem to die, and so they finally beheaded him. Well, as we look at the image of St. Theodore, and we remember those ancient times, it is very easy for us to romanticize the martyrdom of the early church. I think it is worth realizing that, as blessed John Paul II said, we are living in what must be recognized as a new age of martyrs. Martyrdom is not something that we can relegate to the past, to history. And so I'm going to read for you passages from the address by Cardinal Timothy Dolan, Archbishop of New York, to the U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops General Assembly in November of last year. One expert calculates that half of all Christian martyrs were killed in the 20th century. The 21st century has already seen, in its first 13 years, 1 million people killed around the world because of their belief in Jesus Christ. Last April, two of our Orthodox bishops were kidnapped in Aleppo by gunmen as they returned from a humanitarian mission. Their driver was shot and killed. And a little less than a year ago, an Orthodox priest from Hama was killed by a sniper while helping the wounded. The situations in Syria and Iraq wrench our hearts, but the plight of Christians in Egypt is no better. As shepherds of one of the most richly blessed communities of faith on the planet, as pastors and faithful who have spoken with enthusiastic unity in defense of our own religious freedom, we must become advocates and champions for these Christians whose lives literally hang in the balance. Pope Francis recently invited us all to an examination of conscience in this regard during his general audience on September 25th. He said, quote, "When I hear that so many Christians in the world are suffering, am I indifferent? Or is it as if a member of my own family is suffering? When I think or hear it said that many Christians are persecuted and give their lives for their faith, does this touch my heart or does it not reach me? Am I open to that brother or that sister in my family who's giving his or her life for Jesus Christ? Do we pray for one another? How many of us pray for Christians who are persecuted? How many? respond, everyone responds in his own heart. It is important to look beyond one's own fence, to feel oneself a part of the church, of one family of God. End quote. Cardinal Dolan continues. Finally, we can insist that our country's leaders make the protection of at-risk Christians abroad a foreign policy priority for the United States. Protecting religious freedom will be a central social and political concern of our time. In addition to this, I saw 2 days ago in the New York Times this quote from President Obama. President Obama on Thursday scolded China, Iran, North Korea, and other countries known for repressing religious minorities and declared that promoting freedom of faith around the world was a central goal of American foreign policy. Would that it is so. We who are part of the church, especially the Melkite Church, which is an Eastern church, and suffering, along with the Latin churches, and other Orthodox churches in the Middle East, knows well that the church is watered by the blood of the martyrs. That the church continues to be watered by the blood of the martyrs is a witness that, as we heard in the gospel today, the Lord stands with people who suffer. But that does not mean we can stand back simply say, that is the way it is, this is God's purpose, somehow this is kismet or fate. We are obliged, as fellow Christians, as Pope Francis indicates, to understand that our church is being nourished by the blood of the martyrs. We need to pray for people who are being persecuted, and for those who have been martyred, pray to them as well, asking for their intercession for us, that our faith may be enlivened, strengthened, and flower, bringing real fruit into the world. That is our legacy, that is our history, and that is the contemporary challenge of being Church of Martyrs. Glory be the holy, consubstantial, life-giving, and undivided Trinity at all times, now and ever.
Thank you.
promised life and hope of the resurrection. But the Lord God will grant them rest for the just repose of the Lord God. They remember them in his kingdom. Oh, most the Lord God may remember us all in his kingdom at all times, now and ever. Come to be.
Let me remember the kingdom. In this endless sword is my angel host. Amen.
for the remission of sins and for eternal life. Amen. May the reception of your holy mysteries, Lord, be for me not the judgment or condemnation, but for the healing of my soul and body. Amen.
Approach with fear of God, with faith and with love.
Thank you.
fullness of your church, sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. In return, raise them to glory by your divine power, and do not forsake us who put our hope in you. Give peace to your world, to your churches, to your priests, to our public service, to the government, and to all who protect us, and to all your people. For every good gift and every perfect grace is from love and